Today's stream is going to be a different stream from the previous ones. Since the previous ones we discussed about the AmigaOS and we have seen every folder in AmigaOS and their purpose, and we got more familiar, and also we installed the most the first applications that anyone probably would like to install on a brand new installation. From now on, from today's stream and the next ones, we are going to discuss about what someone can do with AmigaOS except gaming, and what else he can run. For example, if someone comes to you, to anyone of you, and asks, okay, that's fine, it's a nice, a beautiful operating system, but what can you do for an everyday user? This stream and the next ones are going to cover this topic. And for today, we are going to see and discuss about music, how you can play music, and listen to online music as well, MP3 files, OGG files, or MOD files. We are not going to see, we are not going to discuss about making your own music. Possibly in one of the future streams we are going to cover this topic. But for today we are going to see some of the applications that I propose to install on your system for this matter. And my first step for today was to update a little bit the upgrade a little bit the emulated Amiga that I'm using here to have a Blizzard an accelerator with an O30 CPU, so to match my classic Amiga 1200 that I have. And I hope that I'm going to use in one of the next streams. So now that we installed the O30 CPU libraries and we are ready to go, we can see the first application for music that we have already have seen in this stream a lot of times. It's AmP. Infinity Music Player, which is one of the best software that you can install on your machine, because not only you can listen to online mods that are downloaded automatically from Aminet and other sources, you can also chat with people in the main window, and it has a lot of features, like creating your favorites list, like sharing songs with others through the chat, or listen to a song that someone else proposed in the chat. Also, you can have a list of the top modules, top 25 modules that people are listening to. For example, we can listen, let's say, this one. By clicking that, it downloads it and starts playing it. And also, there are other things, like even playing games inside AmP. Like here, we can go, let's see here. It has WSD load games, magazines, demos that are downloaded automatically and can be executed. And also other files, let's say here. These are games. Let's click that, execute. And you can play the game as if it was on your machine. And if we go to from here you can download files from Aminet. And let's see a WSD load. Let's say this one. This is downloaded automatically and executed on your machine, which is really interesting, because you can play whatever you want of the games without having anything on your machine stored on your machine. And this is running using WSD load. And if you remember, in one of our previous streams, we installed WSD load, so it uses that installation to run the game. To exit, I just rebooted the machine, because the exit key will be something that I can't find on my keyboard right now. Most of these features are the features that you get if you register AmP. Otherwise, you have just the music playing and only this. But I believe it is one of the applications that deserves to be to register, for someone to register. Totally. I recommend it to all of you to buy it and use it. Other than that, if you have your own collection of mod files, of course, Amiga has a lot of applications to support these files and play them on your machine and listen to the music. And we are going to see some of them. One of the applications for mod files that a lot of people are using is the Hippo Player. Let me first, you can find Hippo Player on Aminet, of course, and let me unlock this file, the archive, the LHA. So what we have here, it's Hippo Player, the version is 2.45 from 2000. And recently, one more, the developer from Hippo Player released a beta version of 2.46, a patch that he's still working on, and it is available on GitHub, but which I tested and works pretty good, but it has some issues. So we will remain with 2.45 that you can find on Aminet, and the application is this. It's it has a small GUI because it is a small player that supports a lot of modules, and you can let me see if you have mod files to sell to insert them. You can do that. Volumes, mods. Let's select them all. Okay. Okay. It doesn't work. Let me see why. Okay. Install. Okay, it needs Hippo Player group into S. Execute command, new cell. Okay, this one. We need to copy that to copy the 2S, PS3M 2S as well, copy PS3M 2S. Okay, libraries required, copy the player libraries you need into libs. Okay, so here we don't have the libraries, but let me see here. libraries. These libraries are necessary to play the sound, the music files. So I'm going to copy all of them except the rec tools, because I think there is one. Two libs. Okay. So if I go and run it again, complaints. But if you watched my previous stream, you know that one of Swiss knife that we have is Snoopdos. Let's see if we can see why it complains. Okay, it can't find the key. Okay, I don't think that's the problem. And also it can't find the hippo player prefs. Okay. Let me see if we have to make any changes here. Player group loaded. We don't have Ahi. Okay. Let me try again. Okay. Doesn't start. Doesn't play the audio. Hmm. Loading modules. Let's say that the modules are here, so it can find it. Okay, program W buffering. Let me do a restart in case that fixes the problem. It shouldn't, because the library seems to be already used, but to be on the to be more sure. Yeah. Let me you see now the emulator with the O30, how much faster it is. And play. Okay. Oh. It seems like it can't open the file. Let me try to okay, let me copy those files into the RAM. Okay. So there is a problem with the files. For some reason it can't access them. You see, file is write protected. Okay. I think I know what the problem is. And it has to do with the files protection. Let me try something else. It has to do with the file protection on the Linux machine. Let me try another file that I saved from Amiga a minute ago. Yes, this one. You see? Now it plays just fine. Not right protected, but they seem to be a little bit. Let me check the. Why this is happening. So the problem was actually the files from the Linux side and not the Amiga problem, because this folder, the essentials, this one here is a shared folder from Linux, so that I can transfer files from Linux to Amiga. Okay, so if I try. Okay. Now it works just fine. All. Here we have all the list. And the nice thing that the Hippo player is have is, hello Amiga Gamer 1200, welcome to the stream. The Hippo player has one cool thing that you can press the right mouse button, and this minimizes the window, so you can have it at the side and do whatever you want to do with your machine. Amiga Gamer, today we are going to see some applications that I proposed to install on your machine to listen to music, mod players, and MP3 players as well. So if you guys have any proposals, feel free to tell me, and we can also see these programs as well. Hippo player in this folder for support, it has some scopes which are interesting applications that you can run to see the music in different aspects. For example, the scope or the pattern scope or the different channels here. And you can run, depending your machine, you can run as many as you want. Yes, this is not the beta version, Amiga Gamer, of Hippo Player. It's the 245 version, because beta is still not so stable, in my opinion. I have seen some issues with the window that sometimes if you minimize it and open it again, you don't see any buttons, it's plain gray, and if you have music playing, it is it continues playing them, but you don't have any buttons available. So after those technical issues that we had and we solved, let me snapshot this window. Eagle Player is one of the applications that we are going to see as well. But first of all, the Hippo Player is very nice because it is small. Its window is small, and you can have it at the side of your workbench without wasting space. Just playing a list of songs that you like. Hippo Player also can use AHI, the retargetable sound drivers. AHI is used basically if you have it supports Pola as well, but if you have any sound card, they usually use AHI to speak with the AmigaOS and the application, so they can, you can hear the music. We can see that how we can install it, but after maybe later, because we are going to use it for another application that we are going to install, the AmigaAmp. So that's a Hippo Player. Hippo Player is one of the applications that you probably have seen on Amiga Bill's streams, because he likes it very much and he uses all the time this one. Amiga Gamer says that he's using Eagle Player or AmigaAmp. Yes. I like Eagle Player a lot. And it has some nice scopes over there, but I find Hippo Player more of my taste because it is really small. You don't waste any space, especially if you do something like that. So you have it there and you can listen to music. But let's see the next one, which is Eagle Player, which I don't have downloaded, but we can download it together. Amiga Gamer, today I changed the emulated Amiga to have an O30 and emulate a Blizzard expansion card, so accelerator card. So you will see that a few things are done a lot faster in our system, and this is going to give some speed to us. Because until now we were using an Amiga 1200, emulated Amiga 1200 with just 0/20 CPU and 8 megabytes of memory. So we are going to Aminet. Amiga Gamer 1200 says that he never saw Hippo until Amiga Build streams. Ah, really? I think it looks like less resources memory than Eagle Amp. Yeah, it is. It is wasting a lot less resources of your Amiga. Of course, if you open 3, 4, 5 scope windows here and there, you are losing some memory and speed. But it depends on your machine as actually, and what you are doing at the same time. If you want to surf the internet and you have the mod player wasting CPU because of the scopes, it is bad usage in my opinion. I think back, Amiga Gamer says that he thinks back in the day I listened to mods in Octamed or ProTracker. Yeah. But those applications also, you can use them to write your own music, if I'm not wrong. And if you just want to have a playlist there and listen to your music, you don't have so big, you don't have to use so big applications. Eagle Player. Eagle Player is one of the players, of the old players for Amiga that is still under development. You see, the last version was 1 year ago, and it is free on Aminet as well. So we are going to download this file. Connection refused. Why? Why do you... Okay, weird. Tries to connect to SG Aminet. Okay. What's going on today? st.aminet.net. Let's try this mirror. Okay. Let's download it. No. It seems there is a problem with the Aminet. Yeah. It seems the... Oh my god. Let me see if I can download the file from the Linux. And while I am doing that, why not play some music? Thanks, Amiga Gamer. Thanks for the link. I'm just unloading right now the application. Okay. Here it is. Let me unlock it on. I always do that. Here, unlock. Okay, it seems it doesn't work. Let me use unlock here and that file. Much better. Eagle Player is quite big. It's 3 point something megabytes of archive. With Eagle Player you can also listen to MP3 songs as well, files, and let me chicken out and let's see Eagle Player installation. So we have that file here, that folder, install. Welcome to the Eagle Player installation utility. Please indicate how the installation should proceed. Okay. Okay, install for real. This procedure lets you install. This installation is optional. If you have the recommended libraries already in your system, then you may start Eagle Player. Okay, let me see what are the libraries. The libraries. Okay. Ah, it has different libraries for different CPUs. That's good. Render, MPEGA. Okay, let's proceed with the installation. and a directory named DiddlePlayer will be created there. So we are going to put it in system. In there we have applications, music, and we are going to put it here. Let's install standard icons. And see how it goes. Installer will modify your user startup file. The following lines assign. Okay. Okay. So it puts an assignment Eagle Player 2 on our user startup user startup file. And so we are accepting that. Install complete. Okay. And there is the key as well in the package. So if we go here, music, Eagle Player, let me, okay, and double click on that, Eagle Player starts, and that's the basic look and feel of the application. If we, let me remember how we load, select the sound module, okay, volumes, essential, mods, let's say all of them, okay. So now that we selected a list of files, SLT Snake, that installer broke in two of my 1200 and Amithlon systems. When you say it broke, you mean it stopped working and didn't proceed? It installs a few third-party libraries. Perhaps it overwrote some of your already had on another version. It should not break your system though, just a few apps that might use those libraries. Amiga Gamer is right. The thing is that a lot of applications that we have currently on Aminet and possibly in other sources are too old, and most of the times they do not check the version of the file they need and try to copy over into various places, for example into libraries or the command, the C folder. So for old applications it will be better to do it manually if you can. Otherwise it is a good idea to start the installation process. Let me show you. If you are not sure what it does and you would like to check before proceed, you can start the installer, let's say intermediate user, and here select pretend and log file. By that, it is not going to, the installer will run until the end, but it will not make any changes to your hard disk, but it will create a log file, possible into the RAM disk or inside the folder of this archive, and you can see exactly what it does on the process of the installation. If you want to be extremely sure what it does and if it changes anything on your machine. SLT Snake says that the system was okay. I mean the installer script, it broke during copying. Okay, possible it was trying to find a file but it couldn't, or a folder. I don't Amiga Gamer 12 says I don't think I used the installer with 3.2. I checked the libraries, got the latest versions, then just copied the Eagle Player folder to work. Yes, that's a good process to do it. Actually, the Eagle Player says that on the installation process that here, the installation is optional. If you have the recommended libraries, you can just run the application. And sometimes you don't need to do the installation. Try to run the application, but first have Snoop Dogg running, so you can see what exactly is missing and copy them into the necessary folders by hand. This is also a good way to do it. Here the Inkle player doesn't show a list of files, a playlist, but you can find it at the menu at the top. I'm sorry. The last menu item here has all the files that it found or you selected on your when you started the application, and you can select which one you want to play and start to play it. Amiga Gamer says, I avoid using installers when I can because I like to have lots of different workbench versions, emulator setups as DS0. I like to have my programs in DS1, self-contained. So, Amiga Gamer, you are using multiple installations of different versions of AmigaOS, I guess, and you have a separated folder, let's say, for libraries that you are also looking that you add in the path of the operating system, of each operating system, so you can have everything in one place and used by all the different versions of the OS, because this is something that you can do as well on your machine. For example, you can keep the AmigaOS clean as possible and have another folder for C, for libraries, for classes, whatever, and add these folders into your paths. So if AmigaOS tries to find a library and it can't find it inside libs, it checks the next folder that you have in your path, and if it finds it there, it can use it. And this is pretty easy to do it. And this way you can have multiple different partitions with multiple different versions of AmigaOS, and all use also the separated partition or folder or whatever you have created, that has the libraries that are common for each environment. SLD Snake says, a DH1 cert for those different workbenches? Yes. Yes, I have a small 3.0 HDF, a small 3.2 HDF, then I have work with the Opus single play. Oh, Amiga Gamer, you say that you have an applications, a work partition with all your applications, but what are you doing with the necessary shared libraries? For example, right now Eagle Player needs some specific libraries. What you do? You copy these files into each and every installation of AmigaOS you have into all the partitions, each and every partition. So that if you boot with 3.2, you have the libraries there. If you boot with 3, you have the libraries there as well. I do libraries manually from Aminet if they are used on main programs. Okay, and I guess you download it from Aminet and then you copy them to the libraries folder of AmigaOS 3.0 and then AmigaOS 3.2, right? Something like that. Or perhaps a user assigned a copy to all DH0S partitions. Okay. So if you need to do an update, let's say for the recently today, Unreal was released. So if you want to use this new version, you download this file and then copy to every partition that you want, right? Because it is an easier way to do it, in my opinion, if you have such a setup. where the AmigaOS uses the C folder, for example, and if you ask for a command, if it is not in C, then it can find it in another C that you might have in another partition. And that logic can be used on all of your partitions, on all of your installations that you have there. Also, if you have assigns that you want to add to all of them, it will be better to create an assign sequence file into your work, for example, and then execute that file from all the other partitions with AmigaOS installation that you have. So if you need to change something, you can do it only in one place and all of them are synchronized. SLD Snake says, recently I was trying to install two different partitions, one for 3.2 and another for 3.1. I have to work on that idea. We can see that idea if you want. At the end of the stream, we can see a little bit the rest of the applications, and then we can discuss about this idea if you want, and we can experiment if you like. So, and also have in mind that if you have a library that is used only from one application, you don't need to copy that to libraries. We usually do that because we like same applications. For example, the MPEGA library, it is able to be used by Eagle Player, but also it is able to be used by AmigaAmp. So, because we don't want to waste space in our hard disk, we keep it only in one place, in libraries, in libs folder, and our application is looking there first if this library exists. But if you have a library that is used only by one application, you can have it inside the folder of the application, just inside a folder that is named like the one that is going to check by default. For example, if this it is a library, you have to have a folder named libs, and inside there the library that you want to this application to load. If it is a command, you can have a folder named c, and inside there the command that, the application that you want it to use. Because the way that AmigaOS works is first checks the necessary file in the global folder, for example, libs, and if it doesn't find there, it checks other paths that are assigned for libs, and then it checks the inside the folder of the application if there is a folder named libs and if it can find that library there. If it fails as well, then the application will fail. Amiga Gamer 12 says some programs check their own folders for libraries. Exactly that. For example, DOps 4.17, it has an installer, but if you don't run the installer, it will check. Exactly. It's not the application. It's the way that AmigaOS works. That's the way that AmigaOS. That's the way when you start an application and this application requires to open a specific library, that's the way the AmigaOS tries to find the library. There is a sequence of folders where it goes and checks first the libs folder, the global inside, possibly inside the boot partition, because you might have it somewhere else. Of course, if you change your startup sequence, you can do whatever you want. First this libs folder, then another path that you assigned in libs, and if it fails, it goes inside the application. So if we wanted, we could keep those libraries inside the applications, and it will work just fine. But we prefer these libraries to copy it in libs because are used by other applications as well. But if you understand exactly the way that AmigaOS is working, you can do a setup that uses specific folders, like I described earlier, specific folders in many different installations that you might have. And to be honest, I hear it a lot from other people that they are using different AmigaOS versions in different installations in their partitions because they experiment and they would like to see which version works better on their machine. So if you have something like that and you want to test things, it will be better to have the things, the files in one place and try to find a way to load these files from all the different installations of AmigaOS that you might have on your machine. Because if you need to make a change, you go and make this change in one place only. And you don't need to care to copy the same file to 2, 3, 4 different partitions. And it is pretty simple. It's not complicated at all. But it can give you also the ability to have a clean AmigaOS with no extra files if you want to have something like that. And that's the good thing that you can do. Actually, based on this idea, the Morphos, I guess you are all familiar with what Morphos is. The Morph OS has the files, the basic file system of the Amiga OS, but also has a Morphos folder where it has the essential and crucial files of the operating system. In this folder, it also has a file system. The structure of the folders are exactly the same like the AmigaOS, and depending on this idea load specific things from the file structure that is in the boot partition and specific things from the Morphos installation. Of course there they change the priorities, but the reason that they are doing that is because MorphOS is able to run the 68K applications and everyone could go there and install Hippo Player or Iggy Player. They want to keep the Morphos installation, the Morphos crucial files and PowerPC executables in a separated folder from the rest Amiga applications that are installed, so that they will not have problems with booting or issues with something that worked and doesn't work after you installed an application and replaced a crucial library of the system. Maybe in one of the next streams I'm going to show you how Morphos has the file structure and how it works there as well. Let's return to the Eagle Player because the Eagle Player has a lot of engines here. It calls it engines. Other engines are scopes that show the music that plays and let's say stereoscope here. It opens. Ah, okay. Error loading engine. Okay, let's try another one. Quadroscope. Error. Why? Let's try. This one. Error. Okay, why? Let's see with Snoop Dossi. It gives us some more information. White fails. Maybe it doesn't find the. Okay. Engines level meter, it can't find the engines level meter, okay. For some reason. And engines. Oh, it's here. Let me see the module's prefs, preferences. The Eagle Player is one of the most complicated applications for me because it has so many different options. Modules preferences, scan directory, okay. Preference fade in, fade out, okay. Load engine. It tries to find the engines in, I think, in the wrong. Let me try something. Okay, proc dir is an assigning for every application. I guess you are familiar with that. Points to the folder where the application was started. Okay, so proc dir here is the folder of the Eagle Player. Okay, let me select this one. Okay. So for some reason it works, but for some reason there is a wrong folder where it checks for the engines. Load engine. Okay, and let's load the stereoscope. No, it doesn't have any tool types. Amiga Gamer says, I always switch back to this default skin anyway. The others use MAT CPU. MB or MB24 are the default. The MB GUI is pretty nice. It's very pretty, but as you said, it gets a lot of resources. Let's open it. But I like it a lot. Especially this spectrum analyzer here. It's really nice, which has different modes. And that's the most of the times you the view that you see of Eagle Player in different screenshots. Yeah, it works. Actually, it works. But the thing is that if you try to open here one of them, let's say level graph, it fails because it can't find the engines, because for some reason it has the wrong path. Let me check one thing. If the assign is already done, if you remember, let me show you that the installation added in user startups file here, this assign, But I don't know if it is already enabled. Yeah, it is. Okay, so somewhere in the configuration of Eagle Player, it has the wrong program mode, it has the wrong folder. Uh, 2.06, the latest one that it was released. This single player 2.06, that's the one. Okay. If you have any inner information about Eagle Player 3, please tell me. Okay. And now let's go and see the last application that I have in my mind. AmigaAmp, which has its own website, amigaamp.de. There you are going to find the latest version and download. Yes, the latest version was from March of this year, and 3.21 69k. Okay, let's download it. Parent downloads here. Okay. And it has, of course, a version, a PPC version for AmigaOS 4. And I know that AmigaAmp uses AHI. So we are going to try again the AmiNet to see if the problem is fixed. Otherwise, and you can find it like AHI USR user, which is now here. There are two versions, 4.18, which is not the latest one, but this version works fine on 68,000 CPU. If your machine has 68,000 CPU, you should go with this version. But if your machine has an O20 and above, you should use the version 6. About that, if you want your Amiga to play games like A Doom that need a lot of resources, the developer of this port recommends the 4.18 version of AHI, because it uses less resources and it doesn't waste any CPU cycles for the sound. Have that in mind as well. For now, we are going to try to download the version 6.0. Okay, it works now just fine. AmigaAmp gets so many updates. Yeah, Amiga Gamer, you are right. Because it is in constant development. So it is actually all the applications that I showed today, Imp, Eagle Player, AmigaAmp that we are going to see in a few seconds, and Hippo Player as well, are all under development. And that's very interesting for our operating system, isn't it? And very it's a thing that we have to be all very happy about and support possible these developers. So first of all, I'm going to I'm going to install the AHI. With this change to 030, this machine just flies right now, I believe. And also, let me unarchive the AmigaAmp. And see how we can install all of them. Okay. So we have the user folder. You see it has all the files in the specific folders with a structure like our AmigaOS. The preferences, the documents, the catalogs, here, the L folder for the driver, for the handler, the devices. Okay, let's see how it recommends for us to install it. Installation. Used to have an installer script if you would like to contribute to one for AHI version 6. Okay. Manual installation is easy. Here is a list of the files in the archive. Okay. As you can see, it's basically just a straight copy to your sys or most sys partition. The exceptions are the magic workbench icons and the help file. Okay. Let me try that. I'm going to copy into my system here. We don't have any other folders, okay. This here. Prefs. Let me check the catalogs. We don't need all of them. So, are there English? No, I won't copy that. And for the docs, okay, we have AHI user guide, which could be nice to keep it. And we have a folder locale here with help. And we can add it, I guess, here. Great. SLD Snake says some basic override operations. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Just as we discussed earlier, it is good to know exactly what you are copying where. And this kind of installation is my preferred one. So right now, only thing that, okay. Maybe our position is a little bit ruined. Okay, that's fine. So now we have an icon here for AHI. Okay, it needs OpenPCI library. Okay, but it opens. And we have this configuration. So it seems that it is okay. Welcome, Awkward Advark. Welcome to the stream. SLT Snake says, wow, I thought prefs disappeared. What do you mean by that? Okay. Now we need to do a reboot for the no, We don't need the reboot. If we go to devices and we go to DOS drivers, we have audio here. So if we double click it, then we should have the units loaded. No. Amiga Gamer 12 classes. I have not installed AHI on 3.2 yet. I am using Pola, so try to avoid extra hardware abstraction libraries if I can. Yeah, it depends on the application that you are going to use. If it is mandatory to have AHI, it is necessary to install it, isn't it? For example, for AmigaAmp, as much as I know, it is necessary. Well, we are not going to keep these magic workbench icons because we can change them with glow icons later from the CD-ROM, right? And we have here anything that we need? No. Okay. Let me install AmigaAmp as well, which AmigaAmp doesn't need any installation. You just drag and drop the folder wherever you want. So I'm going to drag it here in music, in this folder. And I'm going to reboot. SLD Snake says, never mind, I didn't see preference folder before, but it was there at the right. Yeah, possible for prefs and devs, they changed their position after the copy of the AHI files over them. So I moved them again to the right place and saved them from here, snapshot. Amiga Gamer says, yes, so on 3.2, I just use single player right now. Amiga Gamer, do you have network access for your machine, right? You can visit internet. Because I find AmigaAmp really good on playing music from online. So let's see if we can get Pola. Don't see Pola here. Okay, so let's see why we are missing Pola. Applications, no. Internet, download. I'm going to unarchive again the AHI user folder to stupid. Internet downloads. Okay. Overwrite all. I might need to increase the size of the font. SLD Snake, yeah, you're right. The Pola unit is missing. That's why I'm going to see why right now. Amiga Gamer told her, no, I keep my real Amiga offline, but I do have my emulation HDFs on BSD socket library emulation. Okay. SLD Snake says, I missed 2 minutes earlier. Did you install the 6 directly? The thing that we did here is, if you open the folder of the AHI 6, version 6, it has the user folder. And here it has all the files in a structure that is the same like the AmigaOS. So you drag drag and drop all these files in the system, as we read here in this text that comes with AHI, that it doesn't have an installer. So as you can see, the developer says it's basically just a straight copy to your sys or most sys partition. The exception are the magic workbench icons and the help file. And I want to see, I see that it has possibly doesn't have Pola. Let me check again. Devices here. AHI device. Audio modes. Yeah, it doesn't have Pola. That's the reason. So what we can do, is to go again to Aminet and let's search for Pola. Otherwise, we can get the one from 4.18 version. AHI Pola driver. Okay, let's download this one. I found an AHI Pola, updated AHI Pola driver. This archive contains an update to the AHI Pola plugin that addresses several sound quality issues, it says. And it has the source as well and has devices Pola audio and possible for 68,000 CPU as well. So let's download this one. Parent downloads, okay. Here. Quit. And internet downloads. And AHI Pola. SLD Snake says, I think it's needed to install 4.18 first and then install the upgrade overwriting files. Yeah, possibly you are right. Let me try this one first. If this works, because I think that it will work. If not, we are going to do it the way that you described. Installing first the 4.18 version that has the installer and all the necessary files, and then update it with the 6.0 version. So it has here copying. Let me open that. Okay. That's the license. Copying drivers. As a special exception, okay. AHI sound driver do not need to be GPU. Okay. Maybe this one contains an update. Okay. Not helpful. So, what we are going to do, usually when you install the AHI, the 14 bit calibration is copied in utility. So, I'm going to copy that there. And then the devs files, I'm going to get the AHI let me make it bigger here. Okay, and the audio modes. Okay. here. So we should be fine. Let me start prefs and ahi and see if it doesn't see that. Maybe it needs to be loaded. So I'm going to reboot the ahi pola file. Actually, me neither, because I have a lot of time to make that installation from scratch. Let's see right now if it is working. Okay, it complains about OpenPCI, probably because we have the MU10, which is usually for the Sound Blaster cards. So yeah, right now we have Pola here. Which mode do you usually use, guys, on your systems? Do you prefer something like 14-bit stereo calibrated and everything on, or something, let's say 8-bit stereo plus plus? I usually use the hi-fi 8-bit stereo, and depending on the machine, you can play a little bit with this configuration here, so that you can have the best sound output with less broken issues. Okay, I don't know if you listen the audio. It seems to work fine. So let's put here for unit 0. Channels, let's say 4. But feel free to tell me your preferred configuration here. Okay, and it will be better to not have that muted. And put it here. Okay. It works fine. Great. So let's save it. And now let's try to open the AmigaAmp and see if it works fine. Okay, welcome. This seems like it is the first time that we run it. And for decoder, we should use software decoder, because we don't have any hardware here that decodes the MP3s. Okay, MPEG library. Let's keep it low quality right now. And save it. Amiga Gamer says, I try to avoid audio settings as in other areas of my life I spent much time getting angry with ALSA and Pulse Audio. I know what you mean. So, AmigaAmp, the basic characteristic of AmigaAmp is that it looks like Winamp, the old good Winamp that a lot of people used to use on their PCs. And there are a lot of fanatics about this application even now. But also, AmigaAmp has its own GUI way of looking, but most people prefer this GUI. So let me show you some playing some MP3s. No, load list here. Directory, volumes, essentials, MP3s. Okay, need Amiga library. I thought we installed Amiga library. No. New shell. I think that we installed the Amiga library when we installed Eagle Player. Dir. Mpeg. No. No. So Eagle Player didn't install it, but possibly it kept it on its own folder. Let me check it here. Engine single players, no. Okay, let's go to internet, downloads. I have Eagle Player archive here. Not here, it is in essentials. Okay, Eagle Player. And if I'm not wrong, it has the Amiga library. Okay, let's. Let's see if I remember right. Otherwise, we can download the Amiga library from the Aminet as well. Hi-Fi 14 bit stereo and 44 kilohertz. Probably it's needed to edit P96 variables. Yes, maybe. I'm not sure, to be honest, but I possibly it is also needs a lot of resources if you are going to use something like that for the AHI, especially if you use 44 kilohertz. It depends on your machine what exactly you have as a CPU. Okay, 6820. Yes, I remember right. Here it is. Amiga 2.4. So for some reason the installer didn't copy that. Let me do that. Amiga library to libs. And if we try to play some music, it works. Amiga Gamer says, this kicks llama's ass. Yeah, the resources. The resources, especially if you have a classic Amiga, it is something crucial that you all the time have to take care. I saw it working and let it there. Sure. And also, it has some plugins like that. AmigaAmp, and it is very nice player for the Amiga, and it has also a small, pretty small GUI that you can keep it at the side. If you don't want to have to lose some resources based on this spectrum here, you can click on this area and disable it. And on Aminet and various other resources, you can find different skins for Amiga. You can look on amiga-look.org. Let me paste it on the chat. I don't know if you are aware about this website. It has wallpapers and skins for various programs. and you are going to find some interesting applications there, some interesting skins there about AmigaAmp as well. And if you want to play an online radio station, you can do it if you know the URL from here. You add here the URL of the PLS folder file, or the folder of the URL of the radio station, and you can listen to it. Let me stop it here and try to find. I know it is going to be a little bit difficult because of our browser capabilities, but let me try to find a radio station. AmigaAmp supports the Southcast servers. So let me try and find a Southcast website and see if we can play something from there. Okay. Listen. Does it have anything here? Okay, let me find some, let's say, acoustic blues. Zero results. Okay, let's find some classic rock. It should have some results, right? Or the search doesn't work. Searching. Possibly it needs some okay, JavaScript here. Online radio stations. Let's see if we can find any URL to try out. Okay, let's try this one. It is difficult nowadays to find a website that has the URLs of the radio stations available, so that you can grab them and use them with your AmigaAmp. They prefer to hide them behind, I don't know, JavaScript code, and it's difficult to find something good. But there are a couple of applications. I have them somewhere, and I will show them to you next on the next stream. And I can share them with you so that we can use them with our Amiga and listen to online music anytime you would like. So yeah. So guys, that's it for today. That's all I wanted to show you today. Remember that topic of the stream changes a little bit because we've seen all the information about the AmigaOS in previous streams, and now we are going to focus on what you can do on your daily usage of your Amiga. If anyone comes to you and asks you, okay, what you can do about with that machine and with that operating system, that's the topic that we are going to answer with the next streams as well. And feel free to propose anything that you would like to see on the stream. Next week we are going to see also the how you can do the discussion we had today about the folders and how you can have different folders with libraries and that can be able to be used by different installations on the same machine. I find it pretty interesting because that's a good way to understand better the way that AmigaOS is working. And thank you all for being here and joining me on the chat and on the stream. Hope you liked the stream and hope you learned something new like me, because I learned a lot of stuff today here. Together we can figure out the best way to set up our machines. Thank you everyone for being here. Let me check if we can raid someone who is streaming right now and who is live from my friends. How about I see Amiga live and I see Hits streaming. How about going for some gaming to Amiga Live? Do you agree? I think you do. Gaming on Amiga is always nice to have, right? And see you next time, guys, on my next stream. Thank you very much for being here. Have a good evening and see you the next time. Bye-bye.